In this video, we will cover the mobile point-to-point model, which is also called Lee model. The mobile point-to-point model is obtained in three steps. Firstly, we generate a standard condition. Then we obtain an area-to-area prediction model. And then we obtain a mobile point-to-point model using the area-to-area model as a base. The area-to-area the area-to-area prediction curves are different in different areas. In area-to-area prediction, all the areas are considered flat, even though the data may be obtained from non-flat areas. The reason is that area-to-area prediction is an average process. The standard deviation of the average value indicates the degree of terrain roughness. Because the terrain configuration of each city is different and the human-made structure of each city is also unique, we have to find a way to separate these two. The way to factor out the effect due to the terrain configuration from the man-made structures is to work out a way to obtain the path loss curve for the area as if the area were flat, even if it is not. The path loss curve obtained on virtually flat ground indicates the effects of the signal loss due to solely human-made structures. This means that the different path loss curves obtained in each city show the different human-made structure in that city. To do this, we may have to measure signal strengths at those high spots and also at the low spots surrounding the cell sites as shown in figure A3A of Lee book. Then the average path loss slope, which is a combination of measurements from high spots and low spots along different radio paths in a general area, represents the signal received as if it is from a flat area affected only by a different local human-made structured environment. We are using 1 mile intercepts or alternatively 1 kilometer intercepts as a starting point for obtaining the path loss curves. A standard condition. To generate a standard condition, we had specified three steps for getting a mobile point-to-point model, which is also called a Lee model. Firstly, let us see standard condition. To generate a standard condition and provide correction factors, we have used the standard conditions shown on the left side and the correction factors on the right side of the following table. At the base station, let us see first for the standard. At the base station, standard transmitter power PT is equal to 10 watts, which is 40 dBm. Correction factor for this is alpha 1 is equal to 10 log PT dash by 10. Standard antenna height at the base station, H1 is equal to 100 feet, which is 30 meters. Correction factor for this is 20 log H1 dash by H1. Standard antenna gain at the base station, GT is equal to 6 dB per dipole. For this correction factor is alpha 3 is equal to GT dash minus 6. At the mobile unit, the standard antenna height H2 is equal to 10 feet, which is 3 meters. Alpha 4 is equal to 10 log H2 dash by H2. At the mobile unit, the standard antenna gain GM is equal to 0 dB per dipole. The correction factor for this is alpha 5 is equal to GM dash. The measurements is made in urban areas are different from those made in suburban and open areas. Any area to area prediction model can be used as a first step toward achieving the point to point prediction model. Area to area prediction model, which is described here, can be represented by two parameters. One, the 1 mile or 1 kilometer intercept point, and two, the path loss slope. The 1 mile intercept point is the power received at a distance of 1 mile from the transmitter. There are two general approaches to finding the values of the two parameters experimentally. This figure shows propagation path loss in different cities. If the human made structures of a city are different from the city is listed in the figure, a simple measurement should be carried out. Set up a transmitting antenna at the center of a general area. As long as the building height is comparable to the others in the area, the antenna location is not critical. Take 6 or 7 measured data points around the 1 mile intercept and around the 10 miles boundary based on the high and low spots. Then compute the average of the 1 mile data points and of the 10 miles data points. By connecting the two values, the path loss slope can be obtained. If the area is very hilly, the data points measured at a given distance from the base station in different locations can be far apart. In this case, we may take more measured data points to obtain the average path loss slope. If the terrain of the hilly area is generally sloped, we have to convert the data points that were measured on the sloped terrain to a flat terrain in that area. The conversion is based on the effective antenna height gain. The conversion is based on the effective antenna height gain, as delta G is equal to effective antenna height gain is equal to 20 log HE by H1, where H1 is the actual height and HE is the effective antenna height at either the 1 or 10 miles locations. These figures explain the process which we talked about just now. Next, let us find the phase difference between a direct path and a ground reflected path. This figure explains the direct wave and reflected wave phenomena. H1 is your cell tower antenna height, H2 is mobile antenna height. We have a parameter H1 plus H2 as shown in the figure. We have D, which is a distance between cell tower antenna and mobile antenna. Then we have angle theta, we have angle phi as shown in the figure. The direct path power PLOS is given by PLOS is equal to P naught into 1 by 4 pi d by lambda the whole squared. The sum of direct wave and ground reflected wave is given by PR is equal to P naught into 1 by 4 pi d by lambda the whole squared into 1 plus into magnitude of 1 plus AV e power j delta phi squared, where AV is the reflection coefficient, phi is equal to the phase difference between a direct path and a reflected path, P naught is equal to the transmitted power, D is equal to the distance between cell tower antenna and the mobile and the mobile antenna, lambda is equal to the wavelength. We can see that PR is equal to P naught into 4 by we can see that PR is equal to P naught into 4 by 4 pi d by lambda the whole squared sine squared delta phi by 2, where delta phi is equal to beta into delta d. Delta d is equal to d1 minus d2. D1 is equal to root of h1 plus h2 the whole squared plus d squared. D2 is equal to root of h1 minus h2 the whole squared plus d squared. And we can see that delta phi is approximately equal to 2 pi by lambda 2 h1 h2 by d. Now we can deduce the relationships as follows. Delta p is equal to 40 log d1 by d2, 40 dB per decade path loss. Delta g is equal to 20 log h1 dash by h1, an antenna height gain of 6 dB per octave. And delta g dash is equal to 10 log h2 dash divided by h2, an antenna height gain of 3 decibels per octave.